historical perspective on the art of violin playing since the beginning of the recording era. Jascha Heifetz, Part 3. Jascha Heifetz was born on February 2, 1901 in Vilna, Lithuania, a part of Tsarist Russia in the Jewish Pale of Settlement, the only areas designated by the Russian government for Jews to live. At the age of 3, Jascha received his first small violin, and his father, himself a violinist, became his teacher. Heifetz's first public appearance was at the age of 5, and by 6 he had already played the Mendelssohn violin concerto in concert. At this time he was studying at the Imperial Music School in Vilna with Ilya Davidovich Malkin. Malkin had been a student of the world-famous Professor Leopold Auer, and it was to Professor Auer at the Imperial Conservatory at St. Petersburg that Heifetz soon went after his music school graduation at the age of 7. An interesting account of Heifetz's arrival in St. Petersburg was given by Vladimir Grafman, father of the famous American pianist Gary Grafman. Grafman, also from Vilna, was several years older than Heifetz and was himself a student of Leopold Auer. One day in St. Petersburg, he received a letter from his neighbors back in Vilna. Yashinka has been accepted at the conservatory, wrote Papa Heifetz. Would you please look after him when he comes to St. Petersburg? So, after Yasha's arrival, Grafman took him to Professor Auer. Volodya, said the professor, I don't have any room in my class, so please take the little boy to my assistant Nalbandian. After only a few minutes listening to Heifetz, Nalbandian himself took little Jascha back to Professor Auer, saying, Leopold Semyonovich, you'd better listen to this kid right now. When Gary Grafman asked his father how young Heifetz played, his father couldn't find words to describe the playing of the 8-year-old. He only said, he played like Heifetz. And now I would like to present a heretofore unknown recording of Jascha Heifetz when he was 10 years old, the B by Schubert. That was the 10-year-old Jascha Heifetz playing the B by Schubert, a recording made in 1911. It should be mentioned here that this early record was produced when the recording industry was in its infancy. This recording, as well as the others you will hear today, were engineered by a primitive acoustical technique. My mother remembered Heifetz playing in 1910 in Warsaw, Poland, which was then a part of Russia. Heifetz was 9 years old and was playing Mendelssohn violin concerto with the Warsaw Philharmonic. His playing was astonishing, incredibly beautiful and technically amazing. Suddenly, during the performance, Heifetz dropped his bow. But as if nothing had happened, he reached to the nearest violinist, grabbed his bow, and without interruption continued to play. Heifetz's European debut took place in 1913 in Berlin, where he played the Tchaikovsky violin concerto with the Berlin Philharmonic under the baton of Arthur Nikisch. After the concert, Nikisch immediately invited the 12-year-old Heifetz to play in Vienna and Leipzig. There, Fritz Kreisler heard the young wunderkind and exclaimed afterwards, "We might as well all take our fiddles and break them across our knees." In the year 1917, Heifetz arrived with his family in the United States. It was here, at Carnegie Hall, October 27, 1917, that musical history was made. The 16-year-old Heifetz took the musical world by storm and became king and prophet of the violin for the 20th century and perhaps for centuries to come. 2 weeks after this historical debut, Heifetz made his first American recordings, and among them La Capricciosa by Elgar. That was the 16-year-old Jascha Heifetz playing La Capricciosa by Elgar. The headline of the New York Times the day following Heifetz's debut read, "Hats off, gentlemen, a genius." And now, the Moto Perpetua by Paganini, played with incredible technical perfection by Heifetz, recorded in 1918. Thank you. Was Paganini's Motta Perpetua, played by Jascha Heifetz at the age of 17. Heifetz, in his youth, was often called the angel of violin, and it is especially understandable after one hears this charming performance of the Mozart minuet recorded in 1919.
Thank you.
Jascha Heifetz playing the Mozart Minuet on a 1919 recording. The next record, dated 1920 and played with such a divine sound, is the Serenade Melancholique by Pyotr Ilyich Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
That was the Serenata Melancholique by Tchaikovsky, recorded in 1920 by a still teenaged Jascha Heifetz. And now we move to the year 1924. The whole world now knows Heifetz and recognizes him as the greatest violinist ever. We will conclude today's program with a piece so close to Heifetz's heart, the traditional Hasidic dance written for the violin by Joseph Achron. That was the Hebrew Dance by Joseph Achron, recorded by Jascha Heifetz in 1924. This concludes part 3 of our program dedicated to the greatest violinist of the 20th century, Jascha Heifetz. Today's program is part of the series of programs entitled An Historical Perspective on the Art of Violin Playing Since the Beginning of the Recording Era. My name is Yuri Beliavsky, and I wish you a very good day.